Hey guys, what is up? Eric Merced here with another video, and in this video I'm going to show you how to use Infinite Painter and Procreate app together. In particular, Infinite Painter can be used to fill in the gaps in Procreate app. There's a lot of things that Procreate app can't do at the moment, but Infinite Painter can help out. So I have here an image I did back in 2016 of Furiosa from Mad Max, and this is a very loose colored image. And as you can see, I gave her a kind of desert background here on a separate layer. So the idea for this tutorial is to make a nice design for the background. I'm thinking something circular, and keeping the color scheme that you see here for the background, and maybe adding a bit of design to that background and breaking things up to make it more visually appealing. So as you know, then in Procreate we really don't have any way of creating spheres, shapes like squares, circles, anything like that. So this is where we're going to fill in the gap and use Infinite Painter to help us along with that job. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to turn off this background layer because we don't want to use it for the moment. We want to actually replace it. And next we're going to go to the Actions menu and to the Share section and choose Share Artwork. And we're going to export this as a PNG. Unfortunately, at the moment, Infinite Painter does not support importing PSDs. It does support exporting them, but at the moment we can't import as PSD. So we're going to use PNG, and we're going to choose Save Image, and that'll save the image to our camera roll. Now we can just go ahead and switch over to Infinite Painter. Okay, once we're inside Infinite Painter, we're going to want to import the image. So we're going to hit the plus icon and choose Import. And we're going to go to our camera roll and choose the image that we want to use, or the image that we exported out of Procreate. We're going to hit the check mark here because the image will be placed pretty much where it belongs to be, needs to be. And the next step is to create a new layer. And after that, we're going to go ahead and drag this layer containing our character to the top. And we're going to, just to keep it safe, we're going to lock it. We really won't need this layer in the end, but at the moment we don't want to draw in it. So we're going to go ahead and select the new layer. So what we want to do here is to create a circle behind the character, which is going to be representative of the sun. So in order to do that, we're going to go ahead and tap on the tools icon and choose the ellipse tool. Next, we're just going to play around with the ellipse tool to resize it to the size that we want the sun to be. So we're just going to play here with the ellipse tool until we can get a nice enough size, somewhere around there. That looks pretty good. All right, so we're going to go ahead and grab a inking brush. I'm just going to use the first one, the Genet inking brush. And I'm going to go ahead and draw this sun, or draw around this tool. Now if you can't see what you just drew, there's a reason for that. So we're gonna go back to the original layer that we imported, the original image, and we're gonna set the blending mode to multiply, and there we'll be able to see. There's obviously some white around the character that doesn't allow us to see what we're drawing. So that's our sun right there, and we can get rid of the ellipse tool. Okay, so at the moment that looks pretty simple and pretty cool. It looks like a big sun behind her, especially. It'll look that way especially when we add some color. But I'm not satisfied. I want to do a little bit more. I want to experiment with this design and see what I can do. So I'm going to go ahead and create a new layer above that layer just in case I decide to scrap my changes and zoom out a little bit just like that so we can see the whole picture. I'm going to go back to my tools, and I'm going to choose the line guides, and I'm going to draw a line straight across and make sure that it is as straight as can be. All right, and once that's done, I kind of drew right there, I'm going to just move that line to make sure that it's kind of centered right around there. Doesn't really have to be centered, but I just for visual sake, I want to keep it centered. So I'm going to go ahead and draw one line straight across. It doesn't matter if I go over the circle, remember, because we're doing this on a separate layer. And another line, let's make that one a little thicker. Another line straight across like so. All right, so now that we've done those two lines straight across, we can go ahead and get rid of the line guides tool. And the next step that I'm going to do is I'm going to clean the image up. So I'm going to take my eraser and I'm going to get rid of these lines inside of the circle. I'm going to go ahead also and open up the circle, because what I want to do is join these two lines. It's almost like a window. The idea is the sun, but it's almost like a window. You guys are going to see what I mean when I am done. So if you guys notice, the circle does go around her legs right there, her knees. We're going to keep that for now, because we can erase that when we get into Procreate or when we're done with our design. So we're just going to keep that there for the moment, because the important thing here is not the actual layer that contains the image. The important thing here is the other layers where we're creating the background. So now that these extra lines have been erased, I'm going to go ahead and merge these two layers. Okay, so we're going to keep it as simple as possible, so we can just call this design done. So the next step is to add some color to it. We can color this in Procreate, but there is a reason why we're going to color it in here, and the reason is gradients. Another thing that Procreate does not currently support is gradients, but Infinite Painter does. So we're filling two gaps here in Procreate with Infinite Painter. We're filling the gaps of using shapes in Infinite Painter, which Procreate doesn't have, and now we're going to color with gradients, which, again, Procreate doesn't have, but fortunately, Infinite Painter has. So we're going to create a new layer, and we're going to take the layer with our design, and we're going to move it to the top, because we're not going to color on that layer. We're going to color on the layer below it. We're also going to lock that layer so we won't touch it. Okay, so now we're going to select the gradient tool in order to color our background image. But there's something important that we need to keep in mind in Infinite Painter, and that's the use of reference layers. Now, for those of you who know about this, in Procreate, we can choose layers and set them as reference layer one at a time. And the way we do that is by tapping on the layer. That brings up the contextual menu, and there we choose to set the layer as a reference. In Infinite Painter, it's a bit different. It has the reference layer feature, but it's a bit different, and it's actually a bit tricky. And I actually found this out by a mistake. So the reference layer feature is there, but in order to use it, you need to select the layer that you want to set as a reference layer. In this case, I want the layer with the background design to be my reference layer. So with that layer selected, I'm going to go into my tools and I'm going to choose my gradient bucket fill tool. And you'll see that it's all ready to go. Now, how do you know that your particular layer has been set as a reference layer? Well, if you look at the layer in the layers palette, you're going to see that little target symbol inside the layer. So that's letting you know, okay, I'm going to use this layer as the reference layer. So now we can freely move to our other layer that we want to color in with the knowledge of knowing that we're using that layer with the lines as our reference layer. Now, the kind of gradient we want to do is a radial gradient. So we're going to tap on the menu and we're going to choose radial. And we're going to go ahead and drag so that we can more or less set how we want that gradient to look. So I want to give it kind of a spherical look here. I actually want to bring that in there, make it a little bit more kind of roundish, more so like that. Now in Infinite Painter, the way we change the colors of the gradients is just basically by tapping on the little color circle. So I'm tapping here on the white, it's set to white, so let's go ahead and set it to a yellow color somewhere around there. Okay, and now we have another gray circle that's down here. You can't almost see it because it's blending in. We're going to give that kind of an orangey color right there. Right there. And finally, we're going to click on this black circle that's set to black. Let's just set it to 100% red and change it a little bit more orangey, just like so. And that looks just almost about right. Let's change this yellow up a little bit. Oops, kind of changed it too much. Somewhere around there. And that looks right about right. So let's hit the check mark to submit the changes. And now if we go in here and we turn visibility off for the imported image, we can see that we have our sun-like symbol with the lines running across it. Let's turn that back on. And that's a simple design, but now we're going to take this image and basically import it into Procreate. Okay, so before we export this image into Procreate, we want to do something important, which is save the image, just in case we want to come back and make any changes to it in the future. So we're just going to call this something like Sun Design. And we're going to go ahead and click or tap on Save. And that'll save it to our library. So it's there if we ever want to come back and make any adjustments to it. It'll be in our library. So now we're going to choose in that same options menu, we're going to choose Export. And as I mentioned earlier, we can export as PSD files, but we can't import as PSD. So we're going to take advantage of the idea that we can export as a PSD, and we're going to choose PSD as our export format. So now in the share menu, we also have the option to open that exported PSD file in Procreate. So let's go ahead and tap on Add to Procreate. And once the app is done sending to Procreate, all we've got to do is switch to Procreate. And the artwork that we imported will be in our gallery, like so. And the cool thing about it is that we will have all of our layers intact. So we can get rid of this. We'll have our, well actually let's turn it back on. We'll have our line art layer, and we'll have our gradient layer. So we can flatten this and paste it on the other image. But we're not going to do that. We want to keep these layers intact so we can make any changes to them that we want later on. So what we're going to do is we're going to import them individually, layer by layer. We're going to tap on the layer and choose copy and switch over to the other image. Let's go to the tools icon and choose insert and insert or paste from clipboard. There you go. We're going to do the same exact thing with the gradients. And we're just going to go ahead and copy. Close that out. Go back to our original file. Make sure we're under that layer that we want to paste that in and choose paste from clipboard. And now we can just drag our layers to the appropriate spot. Like so. And we can go ahead and basically edit this by getting rid of the color that basically is showing through. But one other cool thing that we can do is we can turn off the gradient and see how this will look with our painted background. So this is one of the many ways that you can use Infinite Painter and Procreate together, hand in hand, to work with each other. For now, until the developers of Procreate add these features in the app. In the meantime, we can use Infinite Painter to fill in the gaps. So hey guys, I hope you've liked this video, and I hope you guys create some amazing things with this idea of using Infinite Painter and Procreate together. If you like this video and you want to show your support, go ahead and hit the like button. Until then, I'll see you guys in the next video. Stay creative and create great things. God bless you all.